Thank you guys. I really love you very much. I appreciate. Kindly subscribe, like and share our videos. Welcome. Today I also have a very interesting topic to discuss with you. Thank you for following. Our today's topic is how to choose a right man to marry. How to choose a right man to marry. Point number one, choose a man or marry a man who understands you and knows you well. This is very tricky, my dear ladies, because you need to marry this man. You need to understand. He must know you, at least your strength. At least he must be able to know your weakness. Because both of you, once you get married, you'll work on the weakness to make them strong. This guy is like, he's weak in this part. He's weak in the way he wear, maybe he dress, something like that. So if you understand, if as a lady, you know this man understands you. You know this man knows your weakness. You know this man knows your strength. Now, this is the right man for you to marry. Point number two. Settle with a man who truly loves you. You need to, as you are choosing a man as a lady to marry, you need to know this person loves me. And for you to know that he loves you, there are very many things that you should put into consideration. For example, he takes your needs, he puts your needs first. He truly loves you in that way. When you call him, when maybe you are down, when maybe you need him, he is there. That means he truly loves you. So you need to understand, if this man truly loves you, there are very many things that he shall do. One, he will encourage you. Two, when you have done a mistake, you'll never be quiet. He'll tell you, sweetheart, this is very wrong. You have done wrong. This is not how things are being done. He will motivate you. These are the things that he can do to make sure that he loves you. So as you choose for a man to marry you, make sure this man truly loves you. Point number three, marry a man that sees everything best in you. That this man sees you, everything that you do is the best. The way you dress is the best. You are beautiful is the best. Your finger is the best. Actually, he compliments you in almost everything. The way you conduct business, the way you conduct yourself, the way you talk, that he sees everything in you is the best. This is the right man to marry, because if he sees everything that you are doing is the best, then you'll have trust in you, because he'll trust you with the house, you'll trust you with the kid, you'll trust you with his properties like the house, the car and everything. So this is the man to marry, the one who sees everything is best in you. Point number four, marry a man who is your best friend. You know, if somebody surely for sure is your best friend, this means that there will be love, there will be care, there will be understanding, there will be unity, because this person is your very best friend. So ladies, if you're looking for a right man to marry, make sure this man is your best friend. He is there for you. A friend is in need is a friend indeed. So when you have any need, this guy will be there for you. If maybe it's financially you are down somehow, although most of ladies, this I cannot put in your mind that for you to know a man, he must provide and all that. If you put that as a measure, then you are wrong. Don't choose man because he is rich. Kindly don't do that, because richness, money can in Azaisha, job can also in Azaisha Pia. So if you're looking for a man to marry, make sure this guy is your best friend. And for you to know he's a best friend is how the contact between you and him. Because if somebody is your best friend, one, there will be no secrets. Two, there will be that closeness. This guy is close to you, that he has no secrets. He can tell you anything. So when you are wrong, he'll correct you. That's the friends. Friends are there for help, for correction, for motivation, and also for guidance and counseling. A person who is there, who is a friend, who is close to you, this is the right man to marry. Point number five, marry a hardworking man. If this guy is hardworking, this means a lot, because if he's hardworking, that means you will lack nothing. One, if you get married and maybe you are blessed with kids, one, you'll not lack school fees, you'll not lack rent, you'll not lack food in the house. Why? This man is very hardworking, he's job oriented, he's goal oriented, he has a plan for the future that he is there for you as a wife. He is hardworking, even if he's not earning too much, but at least he can put something on the table. So this is the kind of guy. And I've said earlier that ladies, don't measure a man to marry because of maybe he's so rich. No. At least if this guy is hardworking, he can put something on the table. When you come together, and push each other, you will help each other and you will grow. So if you are looking for a man to marry, make sure he is hardworking. Point number 6, marry a man who shares your beliefs and values. That is point number 6, marry a man who shares your beliefs and values. So ladies, you are a Muslim and you want to marry a Christian. So make sure the beliefs are the same. If you are a Muslim, marry a Muslim. If you are a Christian, marry a Christian. If you are a pagan, marry a pagan, because you will not have issues here. So make sure that you share the same beliefs, you share the same values, because if you are on the same page, there shall be no problem. But if you share different values and different beliefs, there will be a lot of issues. So ladies, if you are looking for a man to marry, make sure that beliefs are the same and the values are the same. Point number 7, marry a man who makes you happy. Everybody wants to be happy. As a man, I want to be happy. As a lady, you want to be happy. So if you want happiness in your marriage, if you want to enjoy the fruits of marriage, happiness is a paramount. So if you're looking for a man to marry, make sure this guy makes you happy. One, he can give you gifts. He can even make some jokes that at least you are happy. He can take you out. He can do great things, what you like. Because if he loves you, if he want to make you happy, he must know what you like. You know, this can be also a point. What you like, marry a man who knows what you like, so he'll make you happy. Because if you like gifts, he'll bring give you gifts, so you'll be happy. If you like going out, this will be a great one, because you will be happy also. So make sure that this guy makes you happy. When he's there, even if he's not doing anything, when you look at him, that you appreciate, I love the man. This is great. I love my man. So he makes you happy. The way he talk, the way he dress, the way he do things, he makes you just happy. You are just amazed with him. So this is the right man to marry. So make sure you marry a man who makes you happy. Point number 9. Marry a man who you trust. As a lady, if you trust this guy, for example, trust is very simple. For example, if you are dating and all that, this guy is open to you. For example, there is no secrets. Even in the phone, you know the passwords and all that. So if you trust this guy, this is the right man for you to marry. Because if you trust him, there shall be no problem in your marriage. So guys, ladies, you need to trust this man. If he also loves you, if you want to marry a person who you trust. If you don't trust this man, don't marry. Because if you marry a guy that you have a question mark, then there will be issue from the day you never trusted him until you die, or maybe until you divorce. So as you look for money to marry, make sure you trust this guy. And the trust is very simple. This guy has no secret. If it's the cause, you are together and maybe somebody makes a call, this guy will not ignore the call. He'll pick the call. Hello, so and so, I'm here and here. He's not a liar. Because if you are a guy and maybe you are dating and maybe he receives a call, you are in a hotel, then he says he's in church. Now those are question marks. Why is he cheating? Why is he lying? Now, you need to trust this man fully before you marry him. Because most of ladies make mistakes because they don't trust this guy, they don't know anything. So you need to do a lot of research. Maybe you can even give somebody else a phone a new number, you see, like, how will he behave? Like, how will he receive the call, or will he, like, kind of assume the call? How will he react at that call? Will you receive the call, or maybe you'll reject the call? So you need to do a lot of research for you to trust your man wherever he is. You can even do something very simple, like, you know, at the time that he normally come from her job, so you can as well come, and maybe once he enters the car, you enter the same car and sit down the different seats. Then you can text him, "Hi, sweetheart, where are you?" You at least you need to get the trust. If he tells you, "I'm in the car, I'm from job," and all that. No, I'm not saying that you spy your man. I'm saying you need to trust a man before you marry him. So, ladies, if you trust this man, marry him. If you don't trust him, you better break early as enough. So, because once you get married and this guy you don't believe or trust him, then you are ruined and you never enjoy marriage life, because these are key ones. Trust actually is a key and a paramount in marriage, because if you don't trust your man, maybe you'll be late in job because of jam, and once he tells you, "Sweetheart, I'm late, I was from job," and maybe last night you had seen a phone call from a lady, or maybe the chat with a lady. Now, you'll never trust your man, and you'll live a miserable life, and you'll never enjoy the fruits of marriage. So, ladies, as you choose for a man to marry, make sure you believe and trust in him. Kindly subscribe, like, and share. Otherwise, thank you, and I love you very much. Bye.